Because I'm behind you now.
Okay, so we thought that today a lot of what we talk about with World War II is we know that the Axis powers lost and we know that the Allies won, but it's not really as commonly known as why either of those things happened. And so we wanted to go through a few of the interesting things that we thought.
So we've narrowed down why the Axis powers lost to six key mistakes. The biggest mistakes made by the Axis powers, specifically Germany, was engaging in a two-front war. In the West, Germany had to fight the very powerful United Kingdom and later the United States, among other nations. Later on in the war, Germany began fighting the Soviet Union, which forced them to fight on two separate fronts. German resources were stretched too thin and it could not sustain assaults from both sides. For example, in the Battle of Normandy, Germany did not have enough resources to defend the beaches of northern France, which led to a devastating defeat. The Allies' ability to take advantage of Germany's deficiencies allowed the Allies to win the war.
So, the Axis powers had a tendency to underprepare for battle. This was shown in a number of the battles that they partook in, one of which was the Battle of Midway, which was between the United States and Japan in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. And the United States had a really good military strategy for this battle, and they hid most of their military behind the island of Midway and put one aircraft carrier out in the middle, sort of to bait Japan, called the Yorktown. And Japan only saw the Yorktown, and they used a ton of resources to destroy the Yorktown, and they didn't know that the rest of the United States military was sitting behind, or the United States Navy was sitting behind the island. So Japan ended up losing 4 out of 6 of their aircraft carriers, where the United States only lost the Yorktown. And after that battle, Japan was no longer seen as a naval threat, and the United States began to dominate the Pacific. The Battle of Britain is another example of inadequate preparation for battle because the British pilots were outnumbered 10 to 1 by the German pilots, but Germany just didn't invest enough other resources into the battle to win. So Germany definitely could have won if they had sent enough men and sent enough time, but instead they used sort of ineffective planes with bad technology and they didn't train their pilots enough, so they were just not prepared.
June 22, 1941, the day Germany broke the German-Soviet non-aggression pact by invading the Soviet Union, marks the beginning of one of the greatest mistakes made by the Axis powers during World War II. Germany's goal in the invasion of the Soviet Union, also known as Operation Barbarossa, was to destroy communism, create more German living space, and eliminate or enslave those who Hitler saw as threats, such as Jews, Slavic, and communist people. The Russian winter, as well as diminishing resources, hurt the German military. German soldiers did not have access to proper food or medicine and outran their supply lines, which made them vulnerable to attacks. In addition, the Soviets used the scorched earth policy, where they burned the land as soon as they lost it during battle, so the Germans won nothing with their victories. Due to these causes, the Germans were ultimately defeated at the Battle of Stalingrad on February 1943. Operation Barbarossa severely weakened German forces and marks the turning point of the war in favor of the Allied powers.
So Japan had been expanding in the Pacific region for a while because they wanted natural resources, and the way that they found to get them was to take over the islands in the Pacific. But America was also expanding in the Pacific at the same time and had had past conflicts with Japan over islands. So a Pacific war had been expected or kind of anticipated for about a decade before the attack on Pearl Harbor actually happened. And FDR had ordered the US Naval Fleet to move from California to Pearl Harbor in anticipation of an attack from Japan. So war was expected at this point, but Japan's act of bombing Pearl Harbor was a huge mistake on their part because their goal was to sort of eradicate the United States as a military threat by destroying most of their aircraft carriers and most of their fighters, but they didn't. They only managed to destroy 2 or 3 ships. And they also wanted to lower the morale of Americans as a whole. But that didn't work because Americans, after the attack on Pearl Harbor, were ready to fight Japan and they were ready for war.
The Holocaust was another terrible mistake because it was not only cruel and inhumane, but it was a huge drain on the German economy. The Holocaust hurt the economy for many reasons. First of all, an extensive amount of resources went into building concentration camps, transporting prisoners, etc. Also, many healthy people of working age were killed, limiting the amount of people available for the German workforce. Although some say the labor camps helped the economy in areas such as farming and construction, the labor was inefficient since the prisoners were weak from bad conditions and untrained. Overall, the Germans poured lots of resources and lots of money into something where they really got no benefit.
Another mistake that the Axis powers made was Hitler was obsessed with finding sort of the perfect weapon or these power rocket weapons. What he really wanted was a rocket that could shoot all the way across the English Channel so that he could hit England, or that could shoot other places around Europe so that he could do more damage. But his problem was that a lot of the good German scientists had gone to America to work on things like the atomic bomb, like Albert Einstein went over there. His investment in power weapons drained their economy significantly because he pumped a lot of time and energy and resources into it. And this was basically sort of throwing money out of the window for Germany because they didn't get much benefit from it.
World War II and the Axis powers losing had big effects on both the Allies and the Axis powers.
Adolf Hitler and Hirohito both made decisions that collectively drained the economy of the Axis powers. And
in addition, the Allies winning stopped the spread of fascism and dictatorships for the most part. In addition, the United States became a global superpower because the war was not fought on their land. Losing the war was especially bad for Germany because they had to pay reparations to all other European countries, which really hurt their economy.
The biggest and most direct effect of the mistakes that the Axis powers made in World War II was that they lost the war. And off of this, there were a lot more repercussions. Imagine there's no heaven. It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us only sky. Say